Bro, should we call it a news channel?
Yeah, of course, we can call it a news channel or not. I'm not sure.
I think we have crazy freedom to do anything, and let's do that only.
If it's so, let's try it.
So, guys, let's do crazy.
Hello, my fellow archers. Here at ArcNet, we like to delve deep into architecture curiosities.
Today, the day is here. Today, we set our benchmark of ugly architecture. Thanks to Mohit for sharing this presentation. We have not seen this presentation yet, but I'm sure it will be very interesting for us and we can really look into it.
Come on, even I'm interested in seeing it.
Note, this is just a funny video. We are not trying to paint bad picture of any particular building or any architect's work. So, ugly architecture.
Is it fugly architecture?
I think he mentioned fugly architecture in the cover page. I think he means funny and ugly. So what is ugly architecture? Some buildings are so ugly, the only thing that could possibly improve them is a wrecking ball. Damn, this movie is savage. It's even worse when the structures are high profile and expensive, making you wonder how many people who had to sign off at each stage of planning. And construction actually thought to themselves, yes, this looks good. So I think in this presentation, he has tried to put in 7 examples of astonishing ugly architecture. So I think we should just jump right into it.
Yeah, I'm eager to watch it.
Strata SE1 London.
England?
Okay, this is the Strata building. Have you seen it?
Yeah, I saw this. It was something that three of some watch kind of thing. Is that kind of something, a razor blade or something?
I think this looks similar to the shaving device which I'm using currently.
I'm right.
This looks like that Eye of Sauron in Lord of the Rings movie. Tower of Eye of Sauron. Triple Eye of Sauron. Electric razor. It is a 148-meter, 43-story building designed by BFLS, formerly Hamilton's. It is a very old building. Okay. It happened around 20th century and it is one of the tallest residential building in London. And more than 1,000 residents live in its 408 flat. So it is a kind of residential building. I really didn't understand why they were trying to make something like that. As you might know about the wind turbines that are installed, it looks just like a greenwashing campaign where they were trying to promote this energy efficiency or kind of green buildings. So they were trying to integrate it with new technologies. And at that time, I think 20th century, wind turbine was really upcoming and really hip at that time.
Yeah, this is interesting. They're using wind turbines in the building. I think there's an energy efficient or something in innovative way. But I have a doubt that there are birds and other environmental issues. Will that affect the building or will that affect the environment?
Yeah, man, it is not. I think it really affects the migration of birds. They don't suspect that these high-rise structures would be so deadly to them. They are just flying and suddenly a wind turbine comes in front of their faces. So it also creates pressure. It is also not very eco-friendly. And really, have you seen such a building? Just see this kind of building as a skyline of your main city center. How will it look? It just looks like a Gillette Mark III to me. And I think in pandemic, we really require such buildings in our environment when we are not having barbers nearby.
Basically, it is a 148 meter long razor. Which can raise the entire city.
Yes, it is. So next, he has tried to put in Drake Circus Shopping Center, and it is in UK.
United Kingdom. Domino's.
This building is given complexion to a Leaning Tower of Pisa, I think.
It is something. I'm seeing something like a domino's gonna fall down.
Yeah, but I think they tried to do something innovative in this structure.
I don't know much about this building. Can you tell something more about this building?
Yeah, let's look into more pictures that Mohit has shared. Damn! This looks like a blooming flower.
It's a mirror image. Nice.
This looks symmetric and interesting.
Yeah.
This is not that much ugly, I think.
Well, not as... In complete view, it is looking much much more better. In the half view, it was looking much more unsymmetrical.
Yeah, when you see it sideways, na, you it looks like it will fall over you. While you're walking on the pedestrian.
It's looking a bit weird.
So, earthquake angle. Drake Circus Shopping Center is a 425,000 square foot. 40,000 square meters. So, 10-acre site is taken for the shopping mall in the center of England, which opened in October 2006. So, this is relatively new, I think. The building was designed by London-based architect Chapman Taylor and built by Bowen Lend Lease. Situated behind the ruined Charles Church, preserved as the city's civilian war memorial, the building provoked a mixed reception. So people might have hated the building just because the way its side angle looks, the way it looks, it seems like it will fall over the people who are trying to enter the building. But I think they are trying to innovate over here. So as architects, I think it is our duty to sometimes delve into something crazy to achieve something interesting.
Of course, that's right. It's a new version of Leaning Tower of England.
Leaning Tower of England, we can say that. So the next building, the next one is the Elephant Building in Bangkok, Thailand. I think this might be interesting.
Oh, Bangkok and Elephant Building. Oh my God, what is this?
Is this a duck or what?
It's a platypus, I think so.
This looks like a platypus to me.
Yeah, exactly.
But I think in the title it was written the Elephant Building.
I don't know where the elephant is at.
So this doesn't look like an elephant to me.
Where is the trunk? Oh. Oh shit, yeah. Look at the eyes.
You can even see the tail at the rear end.
You are looking at the rear end only. You can see the eyes.
Yeah, the eyes, the ears, the beak of the platypus. And the bald head, which is made up of glass, I think it also reflects the light directly at your face when you're trying to look at it.
Yeah.
It will also blind you. Once you are trying to look straight in the eyes of the platypus, it will just directly blind you.
Bro, I have a doubt.
Yeah.
Is this three-legged elephants or two-legged elephants?
They are trying to work on a new kind of elephant species, I think, over here.
Oh, they are scientists also.
When you are looking in the sideways, you can see the three side legs. This elephant might have six legs.
I don't mind that.
Six-legged elephant. So let's read into the description. So, symbol of justice. In Thailand, elephants are regarded as holy animals and are worshipped. They are a symbol for the power of the monarchy, and a white elephant was on the flag of Thailand. So really, they really have a huge symbolic presence, the elephants. The building is inspired by the characterization of the symbol icon. So Sumit Jumsai is the Thai architect who has designed this building, and it was designed in 1997. A complex having various facilities from offices to shopping mall, etc. So I think this is an office building.
Even this is an old building. The span of the cantilever is too long span also.
Yeah,
I don't know how practical it is.
Yeah, this might be an engineering marvel to execute. But yeah. Really, the execution and the projection and the kind of symbolism they try to create is really defining the ugly architecture, I think.
I think the construction team has been drank a lot of water while doing so.
So the next building is Champion Motors Tower. And it's in Israel. So I think this might be interesting.
Okay.
Oh my God, this looks so cute.
This is not ugly. They are actually, they are couples, I think so.
It looks like a snail hugging a building.
For me, it's looking like a couple.
It really looks like that. Like two couples are hugging each other.
It's not ugly. It's a cute architecture, I think so.
But I think the right building is the main counterpart, as the left one is not interested. It is just like stiff. No hands, nothing. It is kind of forced into hugging.
that too in midst of a city.
So this is the hugging building. So Champion Motor Tower is a 40 floors skyscraper located on Shishnet Hayamin Street in Israel. The tower is 160 meter high, and when it opened in 2013, so my goodness, this is relatively newer. It was the fifth tallest building in Israel. I'm not sure whether the data is correct according to 2020. The project's floor space includes about 50,000 square meter built on an 8,000 square meter field. Underground, there are 5 floors of parking. And at street level, there are car showrooms for Audi, Volkswagen, Seat and Skoda. The rest of the tower is used for offices. So I think this is an office building.
Yeah, it's an interesting building.
The next one is the Iceberg. Damn, the name is cool.
Iceberg, a tip of an iceberg.
Tip of an iceberg. It is in Denmark, so I think this might be interesting.
I am eager to watch it, the tip of an iceberg.
Wow.
Oh my god, isn't water?
This looks like that pin trap where people just dig a hole, put a trap so that animals can fall and die.
See, it's really looking like it is floating in water.
Yeah, this is a little bit interesting, I won't lie, but really it is creating anxiety when I'm seeing it.
Basically, it is not a tip of an iceberg. It's actually a bunch of spikes. Is it looking like a stalactite?
Yeah, this looks like inverted ones. Inverted from the caves, these stalactites are all projecting upwards.
Yeah, anti-gravity.
So I think this was today's daily dose of ugly architecture. But I won't use the term ugly. I would really like using the term fugly, where there are funny elements as well as ugly elements. It is just a point of perspective or point of creative intentions behind a building, which different architects have differently. But really, these are some funny looking buildings. I won't deny the fact.
It gives people to second thought.
Yeah,
people are relating that into different things. Because I think architect shouldn't give them such a chance that people should interpret the building to some other things. So it should be carefully taken into practice while designing the buildings. I think so.
So guys, thank you for watching our video. If you like our video, please subscribe to our channel. Leave a comment or suggestion of topics you guys would like us to make a video in future. I hope you had a takeaway from our video, and remember to check out rest of our videos. And...
Kimley!